Okay, so hey, good day to everyone. So for this video lecture, I will be talking about the overview of the animal industry here in the Philippines. So it is actually the first topic for chapter 1 on ANSAI 21, which is on the introduction to livestock and poultry production. So I will be talking about the volume of production of the different livestock and different poultry animals, as well as the growth rate and even the farm gate price for the animal products. So as an objective for this lecture, so this is actually the whole objectives for chapter 1. So I will be introducing it here. And then for the subsequent discussions, just look into the objectives and you will know what specific objectives that discussion will go into. Okay, so first is assess the status of the Philippine poultry and livestock industries in terms of animal inventory and volume of production, as well as to compare the current year to the performance of the previous years or for the last 5 years, which is actually on your laboratory exercise. So aside from that, identify the top producing regions of different poultry and livestock species in the country and discuss and trace the reasons why the identified regions perform well in animal production. Ang ibig sabihin nito, more on your laboratory exercise ito, but for certain livestock species, may mga regions kasi that are higher in terms of volume of production compared to the other region. So, what is the reason why that region is a higher volume of production and bakit mas marami yung mga inventory nila ng, like, for example, chickens doon sa region na yun compared doon sa mga other regions. Then, aside from that, appraise the advantages and disadvantages of the different animal enterprises. And then evaluate the strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats of the poultry and livestock industry. So all of these are the objectives for chapter 1. Okay, so but for our discussion today, I think it will only be for the first two objectives. The status, we will assess the status as well as we will identify the top producing regions of different poultry and livestock industries. So with that, let's go into our first discussion on our first topic, which is on the disposition of the Philippine poultry and livestock industry. So now first is on the poultry industry. So the poultry industry is a significant component of the Philippine agriculture. So when we say significant, it is an important part of the Philippine agriculture. Why? It contributes to food security and rural employment. So meaning, the poultry industry can contribute to the food security by producing the products of, like, for example, chicken meat or eggs. So it can contribute to the food security. And then when it comes to rural employment, usually kasi yung mga farms, na mga poultry farms, poultry commercial farms, they built it or they will build it on rural areas. So the people surrounding that commercial farm will also have an opportunity to be employed on that farm. So it can increase the rural employment. And then the chicken as well as the duck, and then the another one is the quail. The farming are these poultries are the major segments within the poultry sector, especially chicken. Chicken, lagi tatandaan, chicken is the number one, like poultry industry, and then followed second by the duck industry, and then the third one is the quail industry. Okay? So, various types of production system exist, ranging from backyard or small-scale farms to large commercial farms. So, yan yung parang overview, one of the parang ano ng poultry industry. You have some backyard or small-scale farm, usually ito yung mga pinakamarami. Mas madami yung mga small-scale farms because, one, hindi mo kailangan ng masyadong maraming resources. Another one is that pwede mong i-establish ito in your backyard, doon sa likod ng bahay ninyo, doon sa area ninyo. Okay? And then, there are few large commercial operations. Usually, itong mga large commercial operations, yung mga involved dito is yung mga malalaking company. Okay? So, yan. And then, for the livestock industry naman, it includes the production of cattle, swine, goats, and other livestock. So, magkaiba si poultry industry at saka si livestock industry. Si poultry industry, these are all the poultries, mga bird species that renders economic services sa tao. So, doon yung chicken, ducks, swine, chicken, duck, quails, even turkeys, and even geese, lahat na ng mga poultries nandun sa poultry industry. For livestock industry, dito papasok sina cattle, swine, goats, and other livestock. So like poultry, there is a mix of small scale and commercial livestock farming din. So, kumbaga, meron ding mga small scale production nitong mga cattle, swine, goats. And then there are also commercial livestock farming. Pero just like doon sa poultry industry natin, mas madami yung tao that are involved in a small scale commercial small scale production compared to those commercial livestock farming. Same reason, kailangan ng maraming pera, kailangan ng palawak na knowledge on that livestock, and then kailangan ng madaming resources. Okay? So, yan. Then, aside from that, yung livestock industry natin plays a vital role in providing meat, milk, and other byproducts to meet domestic consumption demand. So, yan. Yung livestock natin, like for example, in providing meat, yung mga swine natin, they provide pork, the cattle, they provide beef, mga ganyan. And then, milk. Yung mga buffalo natin that can produce milk, even cattle can produce milk, and even goats. And then, other byproducts, like for example, yung mga hides ng cattle can be used as clothing materials. Yung suede comes from pig skin, mga ganun. Okay? So, all of this meet the domestic consumption demands. So, meaning, itong livestock industry natin, it can meet the demand of the country for, like, for example, meat, milk, or any other products. So, with that, there are still challenges when it comes to the poultry and livestock industry. So, the industry faces challenges such as disease outbreaks, environmental concerns, and market fluctuation. So, the recent one when it comes to challenges in disease, we have the African swine fever, wherein it disseminated all of the populations of swine in the farm in your area. So, lahat na pinatay in order to prevent the spread of that virus. So, that's one challenge that is faced by the poultry and livestock industry ngayon. And then, other ones is environmental concerns, since there is a growing concern when it comes to like the effect of large-scale commercial farmings of livestock and poultry on the environment. So, a challenge now is to maintain the productivity of this poultry and livestock species natin while meeting the demand for the government or the people when it comes to preventing any deterioration in the environment. And then another one is the market fluctuation, wherein hindi stable yung market natin. Like for example, for this year, medyo tataas yung demand and tataas yung presyo nitong mga inputs natin, and it can affect the market. Baka tataas din yung presyo, bababa yung supply ng mga products natin, meat products, egg products, and any other animal products. So there is market fluctuations. Then, for the challenges, may mga initiatives naman yung government natin. So, the Philippine government has implemented various programs and initiatives to support and promote the poultry and livestock industry. May mga programs naman in order to address the challenges and problems faced by the poultry and livestock industry. So these programs often focus on improving health in order to address yung concern natin ng disease outbreak, enhance breeding practices, and providing financial assistance to farmers. So usually yung mga programs na yun yung pinagpo-focusan ng government natin. And for the economic impact naman, the poultry and livestock industry contribute significantly to the country's economy by generating income, providing employment opportunities, and supporting related industries such as feed production and processing. So, yan. Usually, ito yung mga sa agriculture sector, especially dito sa poultry and livestock industry natin. It can it continually contribute to the economy, to the country's economy. One is that it generates income through taxes and even yung mga binibenta nilang meat products and other animal products, may tax yun. So it can give income to the government. And then it provides employment by employing farmers, raisers, especially in the rural area. Then it provides employment opportunities. And then aside from that, without this poultry and livestock industry, the complementary industries such as the feed mill industry and other medicine and biologic industry, walang mangyayari sa kanila. Kasi kailangan ng poultry and livestock industry para merong pagbebentahan yung mga feed production and processing industry natin. Okay, so they support the related industries such as feed production and processing. Okay, so when it comes to export and import naman, the Philippines may import certain meat products to meet domestic demand while also exporting some products to international markets. So, when it comes to this, parang mas marami pa rin yung ini-import natin compared doon sa ina-export natin. One thing is that when it comes to exporting, madami ka talagang requirements. Madaming requirements that the farm or the meat processing plant needs to meet in order for it to export that meat, in order to meet the quality that is required in order for it to be exported. So usually, konti lang yung nag-e-export talaga ng mga animal products, meat products, yon. But marami sa atin, marami yung nag-i-import ng mga meat products. Why? Para ma-meet natin yung demand, yung domestic demand. May times kasi that the production natin ng like for example animal products, meat products is not enough in order for us to meet the domestic demand in the country. So yung ginagawa ngayon is that they will import. So yan yung parang export and import dynamics natin dito sa poultry and livestock industry. So, trade policies, regulations, and market demands influence the export and import dynamics. So, ang ibig sabihin, we'll not go into deeper discussions when it comes to the policies that they need to meet, the regulations that they need to follow, as well as how the market demands will influence these exports and import dynamics. But these are the factors that they that will influence or affect the level of exports, number of exports that these industries will produce, and then the number of imports naman, values of imports na papasok sa atin. Okay, so yun, trade policies, regulations, and market demand. So, when it comes naman sa adoption ng technology natin, modern technologies including improved breeding techniques, efficient feed formulation, and advanced management practices are gradually being adapted in this industry. Ang ibig sabihin, when it comes sa technology kasi, we are behind compared to the other countries since we are considered as still a third world country. And then the other countries, like for example, the United States, Japan are considered first world countries wherein they have access to the latest technologies, to the modern technologies that will improve the productivity of the animals. But again, for the Philippine poultry and livestock industry naman, we are gradually adapting these technologies. Yes, we are lagging behind, but eventually we'll adapt these technologies and eventually we will increase the productivity of our farm animals, of our livestock animals. And then when it comes to environmental and sustainability concerns, sustainable and environmentally friendly practices are gaining importance ngayon. So like for example, compared noon that walang masyadong concern, walang masyadong sinasabi ng mga tao, yung government when it comes to the environment. But because of like the ever deteriorating environment natin and as evident by climate change, mga ganon, there are buzz or concerns now when it comes to the environment. So, ever so, nang kailangan that we have parang i-prioritize yung mga practices that are environmentally friendly. Okay, so like for example, yung mga concerns natin when it comes to land use, water consumption, and waste management, usually kailangan na i-address natin through adapting practices, environmental friendly practices, while again maintaining yung productivity. Doon papasok kasi yung dilemma kasi yung practices natin sa livestock and poultry industry, it is efficient in a way na it will maintain yung productivity ng mga animals natin. Pero hindi ina-account yung effect nito sa environment. So yung dilemma ngayon, paano natin i-address yung concerns for the environment while sustaining yung productivity ng mga animals, yung mga livestock natin. So, yan. Those are the future parang studies that we can make when it comes to addressing yung environmental concerns. So, with that, those are the disposition natin, parang an overview lang ng livestock and poultry industry natin. Now, we can go to like specific poultry species, specific livestock natin, and we can look into the, like for example, annual volume of production, growth rate nitong mga poultry species natin. So like for example, dito, so by the way, all of these are lifted from the Philippine Statistics Authority when it comes to their report in the chicken situation. So first is on the chicken. Ay, magkikita dito that in 2023, 464,970 metric tons live weight yung na-produce natin. Compared nung 2022, wherein it is only around 454.38. So, medyo tumaas. So, kung makikita yung growth rate natin when it comes to the volume of production ng chicken, that is from 2022, 6.7. compared nung 2021 yan. And then for this year, yung growth rate natin nasa 2.3. Mas mababa compared nung 2022, but at least it is still growing in the volume of production. So when it comes to that, lagi tatandaan si Central Luzon yung top producer natin ng chicken with around 151,970 metric tons live weight, or around 32.7% share to the total chicken production during the reference quarter. So, Central Central Luzon yan. And then completing yung top 5 regions natin, top 1 si Central Luzon, and then top 2 si Calabar Zone, top 3 si Northern Mindanao, top 4 si Western Visayas, and then yung top 5 is si Central Visayas. So all of these regions, sila yung mga top producing regions natin when it comes to the volume of production ng chicken. So, itong mga regions na to, they account for 71.5% share to the country's total chicken production. So, that's a lot. 72. Let's round it off to 72%. That is a lot. Ang ibig sabihin yan, yung limang region na yun, sila yung nagsusupply ng 72% ng total chicken production ng lahat na. So, ganun karami yung pinoproduce ng limang region na yun. Okay? Then the rest of the region, nasa 28 na lang. Yung 28% na lang yung total share nila. So, ang dami pang region. Region 1, region 2, car, mga ganun. Okay? So, yan. Just to give a context kung gano'ng karami yung pinoproduce na ano nitong mga regions na to. So, by the way, this data, this is actually the latest. So, it is on the third quarter of 2023 pa lang. Okay? So, as of September 30, 2023, the total chicken inventory reached around 202.82 million birds. So, ang ano nito, this was 1.1% higher than the previous year's same period count of 200.64 million birds. Ang ibig sabihin, tumaas ng 1.1% yung inventory natin ng mga poultry species. By the way, yung mga poultry species natin, you have yung native or improved, broiler, and then yung layer. So, kung makikita dito sa bar graph na to, yung pinakamarami is native. Nasa 87 million birds. And then, pangalawa, si broiler with around 70 million, and then si layer with around 45 million. Okay? So, yan. Sinabi dyan, population of native improved chicken improved by 5%. Meanwhile, yung mga broiler chicken natin and layer chicken natin stocks reported reductions of about 2% and 1% respectively. So, tumaas daw yung inventory natin ng chicken, native chicken, pero bumaba yung inventory natin ng broiler and layer. So when it comes to yung total inventory natin, yung native and improved chicken accounted for 43%, then followed by the broiler chicken with 34.7% share, and then layer chicken with 22.3% share. So yan. And then when it comes to the highest chicken inventory, it was noted in the Central Luzon. So siya yung pinakamarami yung volume of production, siya rin yung pinakamarami ng mga inventory ng birds, Central Luzon. And then this was followed by Calabar Zone, and then it was followed by Northern Mindanao, Central Visayas, Western Visayas. So it completely reflect yung volume of production, yung top 5 regions of volume of production to that of the top 5 regions when it comes to inventory. So, kung makikita, yung Ilocos region nasa 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Top 8 lang with around 9.83 million birds sa inventory. So again, these regions accounted for 44.3% share to the country's total chicken inventory during that period. Then when it comes to the farm gate price, so by the way, when I say farm gate price, ito yung price ng mga products, animal products, when they are bought in the farm mismo, directly from the farm. So iba kasi yung price ng animal product na yun, like for example yung egg, pag binili mo siya directly from the producer, directly from the farm, compared doon sa price niya pag binili mo na siya sa supermarket, sa wet market. Okay, so here we are looking into the farm gate price ng broiler natin which is around 131.26 pesos per kilogram live weight during the quarter, the third quarter. So this is actually a decline of around 9.8%. So meaning bumaba yung presyo ng per kilogram live weight natin ng chicken compared noong 2022, which is around 145.55 pesos. So bumaba, is it a good thing, is it a bad thing? When it comes to the consumers, this is a good thing kasi bumaba yung presyo ng broiler na kakainin natin, but for farmers, this indicates na although pag bumaba kasi yung presyo, this indicates also that the inputs are the price of the inputs are also declining. So it can be a good thing for both. But yun nga, kung sa farmer, baka mas gusto na mas mataas pa yung presyo. Okay? Mga ganun. So yun yung chicken natin. That's the chicken situation report. I do hope that you have an insight na or an idea na dun sa situation ng chicken industry natin. Now we go sa duck industry naman natin. Okay? Sa duck situation report. So the volume of duck production from July to September 2023 was registered at 6.85 thousand metric tons live weight. Ang ano nito, kung i-compare mo yung volume of production ni chicken compared kay duck, mas konti talaga yung volume of production when it comes to duck. Di siya masyadong ganun ka-popular compared doon sa chicken natin. So, yung ano nito, it indicates an annual increase of 3.6% from the same period of 2022, which is around 6.61 thousand metric tons live weight. Ang ibig sabihin, yung volume of production natin from 2022 to 2023, tumaas ng 3.6% dito sa mga ducks natin. Okay, so this level of production in the third quarter of 2023 was a recovery from the annual decline of 12.1% recorded in the same quarter of 2022. So kung makikita, noong 2021 kasi, nasa 7.53 yung 1,000 metric tons yung na-produce natin, na volume of production for duck. Then bumaba noong 2022 around 6.61, which is a decline of 12.1%. So again, makikita, anong region na naman yung top producer natin ng duck? It is Central Luzon. So both for animal, for chicken, and then for the duck, top region natin si Central Luzon. So it is around 2.10,000 metric tons live weight or around 30.7% share to the total duck production during the quarter. So kung makikita, ang taas na yung 30.7% na share ng iisang region sa total production natin ng duck in the entire country. 30.7 yung share niya. Okay? So mataas na yun. So completing yung top 5 natin ng regions with the highest volume of duck production, top 2 natin, si Sacsayhuayan, and then top 3 sa Cagayan Valley, top 4 sa Western Visayas, and then top 5 natin si Northern Mindanao. So, as of, again, September 30, 2023, the total duck inventory was recorded at around 14.49 million birds. So, ano nito, mas higher siya ng 6.1% compared to the previous year's same period with around 13.66 million birds lang. So, kung makikita natin dito sa pie graph, yung small hold natin, siya yung pinakamarami yung parang percentage kung saan galing yung mga ducks natin. 64.8%. So yan, about 64.8% of the country's duck population came from smallhold farms, while the remaining 32.7% galing yan sa semi-commercial farms, and then yung 2.6% naman galing yan sa semi sa commercial farms. Okay? Yung 30.7 semi-commercial farm, and then yung 2.6 natin galing sa commercial farms natin. So, yan, Central Luzon recorded the highest duck population, nasa 5.15 million birds as of September 30. This was followed by Sacsayhuayan, then Cagayan Valley. And then kung titignan natin yung Ilocos region, nasa 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 13. Top 13 tayo, wherein we only produce around 314,850 birds. So medyo mababa yung production natin nitong mga ducks natin. So ang ibig sabihin nito, hindi masyadong popular yung ducks as a poultry species dito sa Ilocos region. So, these three regions actually accounted for around 56% of the country's total duck population during the period. So, ganun karami. Yung tatlong region lang na to. Si Central Luzon, si Sacsayhuayan, at si Cagayan Valley, 56% na. More than half of the total duck inventory natin galing yan sa tatlong regions na yan. Okay? Then, when it comes to the farm gate price naman natin, again, farm gate price, yung price nitong mga product, meat natin, duck meat natin, directly from the producer, directly from the farm. So, it was quoted around 174.63 pesos per kilogram live weight. So, this indicates an increase actually from the previous year's same price of about 146.33 pesos lang. So, meaning tumaas ng around 19.3% yung ating price ng per kilogram live weight natin ng duck meat compared ngayong 2023. Noong 2023 pala. So, yun yung duck situation report natin. Now, we go doon sa livestock. Sa livestock industry naman tayo. First is the cattle. So, in the cattle situation report, the volume of cattle production from July to September 2023 was recorded at around 51,820 metric tons live weight. So, this indicates an annual decline of 1.5% from the same quarter of the previous year's level of 52,610 metric tons live weight. Ang ibig sabihin nito, bumaba. Bumaba ng around 1.5% compared noong 2020. So, si Northern Mindanao, yung top producer naman natin ng cattle, with around 8,260 metric tons live weight, or that is around 15.9% share to the cattle production during the reference quarter. Ang ibig sabihin na ito, 15.9% ng total production natin, volume of production natin ng cattle comes from Northern Mindanao. So, that's the top one, si Northern Mindanao. And then, yung top two natin, si Central Visayas. And then, top three is Ilocos Region. And then, top four is Western Visayas. And then, top five, Sacsayhuayan. So, makikita na ito yung mga top five regions natin when it comes to the, or top five highest producing regions natin ng cattle. So, as of September 30, the total cattle inventory reached around 2.9 million heads. So, yung 2.9 million heads na yon, it is an increase of around konti lang, 0.4% from the previous year's same period count of around 2.58 million heads. So, medyo tumaas lang konti. So, about 82.3% ng mga total population natin ng cattle comes from yung small hog farms. So dito makikita pa lang kung ano yung parang situation ng ating cattle industry, wherein hindi masyadong nagde-delve yung mga raisers natin into intensive production doon sa mga commercial farms or even semi-commercial farms. At lahat or most of our cattle come from yung mga smallhold farmers natin that owns around 1 or 2 heads ng cattle natin. Then yung 14.3% of the total 2.59 million heads ng cattle comes from semi-commercial, and then konti lang yung mga total heads natin or yung 2.59 million heads, konti lang yung share ni commercial, ni commercial farm natin, which is around 3.4% lang. Okay? So again, kung makikita dito sa pie graph, makikita na most of our cattle, inventory ng cattle natin, nasa small hold, which is evident naman if you observe yung mga backyard farms natin. Usually, farmers will own around 1 to 3 na mga heads ng cattle. Okay? So, when it comes to the cattle inventory, si Central Visayas yung nag-record ng highest cattle population with around 344,500 heads. So, this was followed by Calabar Zone, and then it was followed by Ilocos Region with corresponding inventories of around 248,400 heads and then 240,290,000 heads respectively. So, yung tatlo na yan yung regions, top 3 regions when it comes to the total inventory. So, itong tatlong region na to, it shared around 32.2% of the country's total cattle population as of September 30, 2023. So, kung i-compare mo, yung, like for example, yung regions, top 5 regions ng, like for example, DAC, wherein more than 50%, and yung sa chicken, more than 50% coming from yung top 5 or top 3 regions natin. Dito, medyo mas mababa. So, makikita na medyo disperse yung inventory natin ng mga cattle, wherein most of our regions, they contribute. May mga cattle pa tayo doon sa, like for example, Maropa, sa Cagayan Valley, Davao region. So, ang ibig sabihin, almost all of the regions here, or all of the regions here in the Philippines, may contribution when it comes to the cattle. Then, when it comes to the average farm gate price ng cattle natin, yung slaughtered cattle natin, hindi yung live weight mismo, it was around 172.33 per kilogram live weight. So, pesos, 172.33 pesos. So, this indicates na merong decrease doon sa price ng slaughtered cattle natin, which is around 0.3%. From the previous year na 172.80 pesos. So, yon yung cattle natin. Now, we go to the other livestock, swine. So, in the volume of hog production from July to September 2023, it was recorded around 450,900 metric tons live weight. So, it increased from the previous year of 436,680,000 metric tons. It increased by around 3.3%. So, this indicates, again, an annual increase of 3.3%. So, Central Visayas, yung top producer natin ng hog with around 67,600 metric tons live weight, or it is around 15% of the total hog production natin in the entire country during that period. Galing yan sa Central Visayas. So, siya yung top producer natin ng hog. then completing yung top 5 producing, highest producing regions natin for swine, you have Calabarzon, and then top 3 is in Northern Mindanao, top 4 si Central Luzon, and then top 5 si Davao region. Okay, so sila yung top 5 regions naman natin when it comes to the highest production na swine. So, as of September 30, again, the country's total swine inventory was around 19, 9.86 million heads. So, this was 2.1% lower compared to the previous year's same period count of around 10.07 million heads. So, kung makikita dito sa pie graph, 67.5% ng total 9.86 million heads natin, galing yan sa smallhold farms. So, then 29.2% doon sa commercial farms, and then 3.3% doon sa semi-commercial farms. So yan. Ang ibig sabihin nito, most of our inventory, yung mga matatagpuan mo yung mga baboy natin, usually sa mga smallhold farmers natin that owns around 5, 10 heads ng swine. So, when it comes to the inventory, Calabarzon recorded the highest swine population of around 1.35 million heads. And this was followed by Central Luzon and then Northern Mindanao with corresponding inventories of 1.06 million heads. And then Northern Mindanao, 1.03 million heads. So, kung makikita again, we look into Ilocos region, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Nasa top 11 tayo, wherein we only have around 411,000 heads of swine or hogs. So, the average farm gate price naman ng hogs natin, that is for slaughter, it was quoted around 163.34 pesos per kilogram. So, may decrease ito of around 6.1% from the previous year's same quarter quotation of around 173.88 pesos per kilogram live weight ng ating baboy. So, the volume of goat naman natin, so this is for goat situation report, as of September 30 ulit, it was recorded at around 17.75,000 metric tons live weight. So, this indicates an annual increase of around 0.1% from the 17.72,000 metric tons live weight, and then of the same period of 2022. So meaning meron lang konti lang yung increase sa volume of production. Noong 2022 it is around 17.72,000 metric tons. Noong 2023 it is around 17.75 metric tons only. So, when it comes to the volume of production ng goat natin, si Central Visayas, yung top producer of goats natin with around 2.27,000 metric tons. This was followed by Ilocos region. So, top two producing region natin, si Ilocos region with around 2.23,000 metric tons ng of the volume of production for goats. Followed by BARMM, and then followed by Northern Mindanao, and then yeah, completing the top 5 is Davao region. So, as of September 30, the total goat inventory was estimated at 3.86 million heads. So, this reflects a decrease of medyo mababa lang of around 2% compared with the previous year's same period count of 3.94 million heads. So, medyo mababa yung binaba lang na ano natin, na inventory natin ng goats. So kung magkikita dito, about 99.2%. So ang dami niyan, ang taas niyan, 99.2% of the country's goat population came from smallhold farms. So meaning 99%, sabihin na lang natin 99% ng total inventory ng 3.86 million heads na yun, galing yan sa smallhold farms. Ang ibig sabihin, most of our country's goat, yung population natin ng goat, galing sa mga smallhold farms natin. Yung mga nag-aalaga lang ng not more than 20, not more than 10 heads of goat. So almost, if you observe, almost all rural areas naman, merong alagang goat. So it contributes to that 99%. And then, konti lang yung mga tao, or konti lang yung goat that are considered coming from commercial farms. Around 0.37%, mababa na yan. And then sa semi-commercial farms, 0.39%. So makikita na medyo talagang most of our goats doon sa smallhold. And this also reflects yung situation natin dito sa goat industry, wherein walang masyadong parang raisers, companies that are heavily invested or interested when it comes to goat farming. So makikita naman dito sa pie graph natin, wherein pag commercial kasi, usually yung mga mayayaman yan, usually mga companies yan, around 0.37% lang. Meron pa rin nag-i-invest dito sa goat farming, but again, minimal, 0.37% lang. So, when it comes to inventory, si Central Visayas, yung highest, yung top 1 region natin with around 627.68% or 1,000 heads ng goats. This was followed by Central Luzon and then Western Visayas. So si Ilocos region nasa top 4 with around 374.73,000 heads ng goats. And when it comes to the average farm gate price of goat for slaughter, it was quoted around mataas, 246.02 pesos per kilogram live weight. So this was actually 10.9% higher compared to the previous year's same period of average farm gate price of around 221.80 pesos. So tumaas ng around 10.9% yung farm gate price natin ng goat. So with that, those are the situation natin, the report natin of the livestock. Those are the available reports ng Philippine Statistics Authority when it comes to the situational report of our different poultry and livestock species. I do hope that PSA will go into in the production ng quail, kasi siya yung top 3 naman natin when it comes to poultry, as well as I do hope that it will go into yung production ng sheep naman. Okay, but for now, these are all the available data that I can gather, reliable data that I can gather when it comes to the volume of production, inventory of this livestock species natin as well as poultry species natin. So with that ends our first topic discussion on the overview of the animal industry, both for livestock and poultry industry. So with that, I do hope that you listen and watch the video lecture on this first topic natin. I will be uploading this video lecture at the MVLE, and then you can watch it from there. So thank you again for listening.